Hello, I am back for another video of my YouTube channel on the Canucks and the Rivals of the Wild on the Stanley Cup playoffs. Let me adjust my thing here. You're so blurry. Okay, let's continue. So, game four. I'll put on the pro mode this time. And Canucks versus Wabos the Wild. Game four starts now. Enjoy, everybody. Let's start. Sorry, it's kind of blurry. Should be fine, I think. Should be good enough, I think. Just hang on for 1 minute here. Let me focus my iPad here. That should be good enough. There you go. Next one, now it's focused. Let me change my settings here. Game settings. Change the difficulty to pro. Let me check again, let's see if it's right. And it is. It's on pro. Let's see if I can do this on pro. Enjoy, everyone.
Hockey fans can appreciate it. It's a clean sheet of ice and we are about to get underway. This is what you play for. Moments like this, you can feel the energy in this building and we are underway. Nice pass. Lots of goal from the back end and a great save. Vancouver's got the puck along the boards. Stop by the walker. Vancouver's got it along the wall. Now a quick pass to Besser. Looks to set up along the point. And that puck leaves the zone. He's got a step. What a stop by the goaltender.
Yeah, he was able to gauge his speed against the skaters. He moved back nicely with them to make the stop.
Pretty cut and dry with a tripping call here.
Yeah, but James, every player argues the tripping call because you feel like the stick was in the right place and the other guy stepped on it.
Yeah, it looked like there was some late moment lobbying there.
bound for tripping. I always hated taking tripping penalties. It always felt like there was something I could have done better than that. Stop by the goaltender. Solid hit on the play, and that knocks the puck off his stick. Ken is caught with the hook, and the official saw it. Fires it into the offensive zone. Let's see what the official says here. And it's going to be 2 minutes for hooking on the call. A lot of people debate, is this a lazy penalty to hook?
I don't know if it's lazy all the time, but it's a penalty of being out of position. Your stick's parallel to the ice, you get called all the time. Off the draw, and nice job locking up his opponent. Minnesota's got it across the line. Back to the point it goes. And he makes the save. The nice leg hand.
Oh, he followed the puck really well there. A couple of good stops.
Vancouver's got the puck shorthanded. Comes up with a stop. There's another stop. He's right on it. Two consecutive saves. Tough ones at that. Takes the pass. Big save. Scooped up along the wall by Dumba.
They totally controlled the puck here off the shift. Now they've worn the opposition.
Trying to shake the defender. All alone. Move to the middle. Let's it fly. He scores. A shorthanded marker.
I don't think that a penalty kill has ever really worked on shorty, but if the opportunity's there, now they're more aggressive than they've ever been. This is why you keep your head on a swivel. Defensively, you've got to find where the open man is. Otherwise, you've got a guy standing there pounding a one-timer from the high slot.
Vancouver's made their way back to center ice here, and they've got that 1-0 lead.
The road is a funny place to play. You can't really be too aggressive, but when you get an early lead, James, you can open it up a little bit.
Here he is, wrestling on net, stones him in front. Minnesota's had the scoring opportunities, but they still trail here in the first. The frozen biscuits dropped, and we are back underway here. And now he moves it to Sutter. Here they come on the attack. And here's a shot, and that one's turned away. The Wild have the puck against the boards. The power play looking in. Scores! Oh, that was a beauty!
Right, just stop thinking about the first one. Now you got another. That's 30 seconds of work.
Conversely, it's a bleeding for the other team.
And that is a kick in the shins right there. They just couldn't stop the bleeding. That's a really good shot. The goaltender's down in the butterfly. He thinks he's got mostly everything covered, but apparently not. The puck gets by him.
Minnesota's down early here in this first period, despite the scoring opportunities they've had. Coyle's won the draw here in the open ice. Unloads the shot! Can't get it to go! Vancouver's on the attack. We got a delayed call coming up here as the referee raises his hand. Trucker's going off for charging.
Like every player in the history of the game, he doesn't like the call, but he's going to have to go serve his minor penalty.
The Canucks have a 4-on-3, but not for long.
Everybody has to fight for the puck. Get it quickly, because you're not going to have many opportunities. Not that long, a 4-on-3.
From the slot, wrist shot. Vancouver's gained possession along the boards. Jostled off the puck. Puck dumped in. Vancouver's looking to break out of their own end. Vancouver's across the blue line. Can't get it to go. Puck picked up by Jesser. Picks off the feed. Into the offensive end now. Moves it quickly over to Cooney. Vancouver's got a hold of it against the wall. Can't maintain possession after that hit. And the puck leaves the zone going back to center ice. Pokes the puck away. Vancouver's got a hold of it along the wall. Trying to get back on the attack now. Rodine stick handling in his own zone. Here's the pass. Heads deep. Scores!
Get any of these odd man rushes in the game. game, so when you do get one, you better take advantage. Really nice play.
Minnesota's cut the lead to one. They're back at center ice and ready to get back into this thing.
My favorite part about this is the coaches on both benches are going to be pulling their hair out. I like goals, they don't.
Love offense. Let's do it. Takes the feed from his netminder. Here's a chance to clear the defensive zone. And they do just that.
I thought they did a pretty good job there, James. That's a time you can get yourself running around in the zone. They didn't get there.
Winds up, lets it go. Comes up with a stop. Minnesota's going to be able to kill a few seconds off now with the puck. Tenato's feeling that, and someone's going to the box. Official blows the whistle. Let's see what the call is. Pretty nasty whack and slash in the goal.
If you're going to slash somebody, don't slash them in the pants where it makes all kinds of noise. He gets called up for that almost every time.
Directs it on over to Hughes. Their man's now out of the box, and they'll take advantage on the power play. Takes it across the blue line. Here's a short pass to Koivu. A chance to shot, and that one's broken up. Trying to get the puck out of the zone. And he's able to move the puck across the blue line and out of harm's way. Feeds it to Parisi. And they'll be forced to tag up after that missed pass. Miller's got it along the way. Comes up with a good save. Plenty of playing time left in this frame. Minnesota's still down a goal here, but they have really picked up the tempo these last few minutes. Suter's picking up momentum through center. He grabs the puck here on the point. Dives on the play from the place 99 made famous. Takes the shot, blocked in traffic. Quick pass over to Ben. Takes the feed. Can't keep a hold of it. Slides it over the pace to Suter. Slides it across. Ahead of steam. Scores!
You get it, and you miss the net by that much.
Right up front! the lead. While the centers are jammed up, nice job by the winger to steal the puck. Pulls the puck inside the offensive zone. On the backhand, stopped by the goaltender.
Launches the letter, breaks the spot on a difficult chance. Oh, look at that. Here we go. We got a penalty coming up right here.
Tripped him up, and he's off to the box score, Ray.
Reaching out for the puck to get your stick into his feet. This is the consequence.
Vancouver's power play unit puts their hard hats on as they go back to work.
Down one, a chance to tie on the power play. What a great chance for them here. But you can't stress. You have to be confident and aggressive, but don't force anything.
Vancouver's got the puck along the wall. On their heels, trying to clear. And his teammate comes up with it. Big time stop there. Takes that pass back to the corner. Craig picks up, playing with the defender. And manages to clear the zone. Can't keep a hold of the puck after that play. Loose puck battle along the boards. And a poke check knocks the puck away. Vancouver's got it in the offensive zone. Shots him down. Oh, what a really big stop.
Really good stop. After he made the first one, he's got to find the puck and he's in position again.
Minnesota's got the lead here late in this first period. First period nearly in the books here. Tries to clear the puck, and he gets the job done. Big thumbs up clearing that one. Puts it hard into the wall. Gets that puck back on a stick. Brings the iron. Tries to get the puck over to Pearson. What a stop.
Get a look at that crushing hit again. Right along the board, he finishes right through the player.
Minnesota's been the better team here in this first period. More shots and more goals. Just a better all-around execution. Puck is dropped and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. Gets it out of his own end. Vancouver's got the puck along the boards. Dished on over to Besser. Besser's got on the offensive end. And he says no! Minnesota's execution has been on point so far here in this first period. Back underway, and they take possession here inside the offensive zone. Gets in front of it, crosses the puck loose, and manages to clear the zone. Slides it over to Pedersen. The first period is over as the horn sounds. We'll bat down the hatches. If the first period was any indication, we are in for a shootout tonight. It's 3-1 after 20. Two more periods still to come. We'll be right back with much more action here on EA Sports. Well, after an intriguing opening period, here we go. It's period number two. Puck is dropped and we are underway. Randy, we've already got 20 minutes under our belt here. What are your thoughts on this one so far?
Minnesota's got the lead in a game that's had all kinds of chances, in particular because they've had the majority of shots on goal.
Vancouver's gained possession along the boards. Control of it now from their own end. Dives in front of the shot to block it. Hangs onto the puck. High speed at center, moves on ahead now. With possession along the wall. He scores and got four straight.
They seem stunned, but they cannot stop the puck. Four straight goals. That's just a dominating stretch of play. Oh, I thought he had this game. He got a big chunk of it, but it just slowly trickled past him and into the net.
Minnesota's got the lead here early in this second period. Their offense has been clicking at all cylinders thus far. Quick pass to Stahl. Now he angles it across to Vertanen. And a great save! Solid check to slow him down. Into the offensive zone. Along the half wall with the puck. Takes the feed. Snaps it onto the net. Stop by the goaltender.
Picks it. Oh, here we go. You know the crowd would love to see this.
Yeah, well, look at this, James. I mean, with the goalies involved.
We got to take a stop here, Razor.
Yeah, these teams don't like each other, James. This is not surprising.
Goalie fight. Also, it is. Not enough, I don't do it anymore, but back in the 80s, you can do whatever you want. It's like Paul Probert and other fighters back in the 80s.
Takes a stop shot from the point, and the lead's
And lose this game, game five is the finisher at home. Game five won't be until Saturday. Or you bring up maybe the clincher.
Here's a shot, comes up on the stop as he got a piece of the blocker on it.
And now he tries to get it across to Berman. Offside the call, and we'll have a face off.
They have a chance.
great playoff action tonight for Ray Ferraro. My name is James Cebulski. We'll talk to you next time where the fun will continue.
Well, that's the end of the Canucks at the Wild with the Wild, Game 5, right, scratch that on Game 4. Game 5 will be on Saturday at 7 o'clock, Game 5 finisher for Canucks. I might put it back in my in semi-pro or leave it on pro. I'll choose whatever difficulty I can choose for myself for Saturday at 7 o'clock. And that's the video of my YouTube channel on the NHL Stanley Cup Playoffs 2020 in my game, the Canucks Playoffs. That's it, my video. And please subscribe to my YouTube channel and push that like button and live long and prosper. Bye, everyone.